I thought we played well. We played clean it up in the D zone, but we're getting our chances offensively, and I don't know, it's going to be a close one, but we just got to stick to it.
One period we were working them down low, and then take out penalties, and they start to get the momentum, and kind of we kill those penalties off, but end up burying one after that, and he's going to get back to the basics out there. We're trying to do things a little too complicated right now, and start shooting things in, working down low, and getting shots on net. We don't have nearly enough shots this game.
I thought the RPI came out and played hard. They were intense, they possessed the puck down low, had a few good chances, but we were able to weather the storm, and luckily the team played hard, came out in the third, got a huge tying goal, and then unfortunately our RPI got one, but we never gave up. We battled right back, and I think that we definitely could have won that game. If credit to RPI's goalie, made a huge save in overtime. That probably saved the
night's game. This afternoon's game, I should say, was an interesting one because I didn't think we were very good at all for two periods, and just didn't have legs, didn't have energy, didn't have that desire that we need to have because we're a team that needs to outwork opponents intelligently and have that energy level for us to be successful. So through two periods, I honestly thought there were two players out of 21 that were dressed that actually played well. Our goaltender, Anthony Borelli, who I thought played tremendous in the second to keep us actually alive in that game. And Jeff Ryan, who I thought was had a lot of energy all night. Interesting, you know, that in the third we're able to switch up turn the switch on and somehow find the reserves to play a great third in a great overtime. We tie it up and then we go down and then we score again. So this team has like huge hearts. Biggest hearts of any team that I've ever been involved with or coached. I mean, we refuse to cave because today would have been easy because we just did not have that energy and found a way to get a point. Disappointing, in our home record is very interesting because we have yet to get beat at home in the league, but we have yet to win. So we're 0-4 at home with some real battles, and comeback points. These points are all important, So. What we're going to do is get healthy. We have some guys that are down, guys that are playing that are injured, that gutted it out. But hopefully the guys come back and have a chance to heal, go into exams and do well on the academic side, and then come back ready to attack the second half. The guys, it was as I was mentioning, but it was interesting. What's going to help us is we have certain guys that we rely on a lot, which most teams do, and ultimately the game usually boils down to those guys that we rely on making some plays. And in the third, we made some plays. Manny Laurito made a wonderful play on the second goal, I believe. He's an absolutely effortless skater, an elite level kid in our league already. You're talking about a guy that missed 10 games last year, so he's still finding his way. But man, is he a dynamite player? I just think if we can get Nick Lappin back healthy, he's been hurt basically the whole year with groins, and that's not an easy thing to play through. He tried and he couldn't play this weekend. If we can get some of our other guys like Matty Wall has been done up and he's been playing. They just got to get healthy, but we had chances and we had a bona fide overtime backdoor goalie, nowhere to be found. And that kid made a great save, tribute to them. But they're a good team. I was impressed with how hard they play. you know, how intense they came out, and I knew they would. They're very well coached. They have 18 full scholarships, and they should be a good team, and I thought they were. And challenge for us, but I think we rose to the challenge in the third, so I'm proud of the guys. I mean, would have liked to have that win or a win on the weekend, but we'll take two ties and grow and get better. And as I tell the guys, we just got to, you know, win every day in practice, you know, in games. And it's a process. And I know it's overkill, but it's a process. We just got to continue to get better. We're very young in critical areas, and the guys have to grow. So the lesson we learned tonight is you can't wait two periods before you decide to find the energy reserves in your legs and find that passion that we need in order to be successful. But if it's a lesson that's constantly learned, then that's not an intelligent hockey team. So I told the guys, learn your lesson, and I don't want to repeat. Going to break with a positive, going to a break with some good things that happened. So it was a strength at the beginning of the year. I mean, we just struggled the last three games on the kill, and tonight was an improvement. So as you just don't focus on the past, but we have to get better in those areas. I mean, we're not going to be successful giving up power play goals after power play goals. It's not going to happen. And we gotta stay out of the box too. Like second period tonight, we're our own worst enemy. You know, we take a penalty 200 feet from our net. I mean, it's goofy stuff. It's stuff that has nothing to do with helping our team win, nothing. And until that ends, until the guys get mentally crisp and understand that, you're going to put a team needlessly on the power play, and that's not good. But improvement with the kill, so we just got to keep working on certain things.